Hey, doggy. Anyways, back here at the ranch, looking at this John Deere again. Alternator works perfect for it. Just it has a problem when it's real cold out to start. So we're gonna get to the bottom of things today and figure out why it's not wanting to start when it's cold. Now there's a couple things I want to take a look at. One being the block heater. I want to make sure that when you plug it in, that you hear the block heater like boiling the coolant. So you'll want to put your ear against the, you know, in the general area of where it plugs in, and listen to if you hear any gurgling. If it's gurgling, it's good. The other thing I want to take a look at it is, well, this could happen in any kind of weather, but for it to be hard to start, sometimes there's a little electrical contact for that injection pump that gets a little corrosion on it, and it's not giving it the full 12 volts, causing that pin to come on and off. Now this looks like it's a manual, so there's nothing electrical, so that can't be the problem. But I know, like, when you turn a key on a Volkswagen, it moves that gives 12 volts to that pin, causing it to turn the fuel on. Another thing I want to take a look at is the fuel filters. If the fuel filters are you know, getting pretty clogged up, or getting, I'm not even really sure where they are. I'm gonna have to do some digging to find where they are. But anyways, if the fuel filters are getting got a few miles on them, then we'll have to remedy that by just simply changing another them. Thing I'd like to take a look at is the batteries. He said that they were replaced a year ago, so I'm wondering, you know, I'm thinking that they're obviously good, but you never know. He said that it just has been hasn't been starting good lately with this colder weather, so I'd like to take a look at the condition of the batteries and make sure that there's good clean contacts, that's getting a good voltage down to the starter. So these batteries are Kirkland batteries. I think that's Costco. Anyways, yeah, you see by the date it's 10/10 it was manufactured, so they shouldn't be failing, but maybe one is a little weak. The owner tested them, but I don't know if he isolated each one. So I'd like to isolate each one and see if one is weaker than the other one. So that very well could be the problem, but I'll keep looking. I don't see any corrosion. Everything looks really good down here, but who knows, maybe that wire is rubbing or something like that and getting frayed that goes down to the starter. I'll take a look at that.
What's all the taping for, anyway?
Well, it's for all the YouTubers that are, you know, have a broken down tractor at home that wants to know how to fix their hard starting tractor. Well, anything, it could go for like a lawn tractor or anything.
Oh, cool. I think there's not far enough in there yet.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's happening. I'm probably gonna grab a hammer.
Yeah, this little, I've never seen a little thing like this. That's
really?
No.
Yeah, I know. That's the type of kids.
Oh, I got it. I got it now. Yeah, so it just slips on there. You put that right on the post. I did get it, and it just came up now. That's a little handy dandy tool there. That's pretty cool. Yeah, so now we got to do this one.
Actually, that one down.
Okay, so we isolated and we're checking this one. And see, it looks fine right here. Put a load on. But that one
can't do anything.
That one's just along for the ride. She's junk. I heard a sizzle there. Yeah, so maybe I'm kind of curious. Does it have enough battery acid in it? We can check that, but that's definitely got to come off.
I better grab the cloth and paint first.
And then we'll get this one.
Because this thing is really hot.
Okay, put that load on.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, that one's good. So,
well, that definitely could make a difference, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Holy sh! You're taping.
All right, try that again. Yeah, that battery's toast.
Just a minute. How did it just go back up?
It went back up?
Yeah, now it's up in the good zone again.
Yeah. That's weird. Why would it do that? Well,
try again. It's like it wasn't connecting right for the first time.
But why would it do that though?
Just a bad connection with the ground, maybe?
No, but it had the full volts on.
Oh, when it went on first.
Yeah, and then it went down to nothing.
Well, how's that possible?
I don't know.
That's really weird.
And I'm holding this so it's not touching. I don't want that.
You're just an Energizer bunny here. Juicing around.
Yeah, I'd be afraid to call John Deere.
Well, I imagine it'd probably be like $200 or something like that.
Yeah, this electric water heater is, it actually circulates the fluid, unlike some that just boil that one spot. But yeah, if it's circulating the fluid and it's not functioning, then yeah, that on those really cold days, it's going to, of course, affect the starting.
Mm-hmm.
And then it just runs so much smoother when you have it warmed up on those minus 20, minus 30 Jeez. Days. And yeah, so if it, that's nice that it has that circulating pump right in it and it heats it up. But yeah, I would definitely invest in something like that. All right, let's take a look at your fuel filters. Okay, so this is the fuel tank. Follow it down. And then we look, follow that fuel line. And it comes to this. Now this looks like some kind of fuel heater because it's connected to the block, so I'm just taking a look at this, and it was pretty covered in diesel, so a little tiny air leak of any kind of fitting or anything that is leaking a little bit will cause air to get in the system and will cause it to be hard to start. Anyways, this is like a fuel pump, so you can pump fuel up, follow that, and then there's probably a cartridge fuel filter in there, but once we get the fuel, once you get that cover off, it's gonna make a big mess because it's probably completely full of diesel. So yeah, I'm probably gonna have to figure out what Wick's part number or something that is, so we can get the fuel filter, like cross-reference it, and probably save probably a third of the cost of what John Deere wants for the exact same filter. But who knows, maybe John Deere's reasonable on this one, but I'm not sure. They did adjust their prices because they were gouging people, and farmers are not stupid. They'll just go for the lowest tender, right?
So, the
truth. Yep, so I guess we'll have to do a little bit of investigating.
2x4 and a spike is all you care about.
All right, well, we got the batteries out of the way there. And that one battery is kind of weird because it tested good again, but this one is definitely stronger than that one. So, and then this, we took that blue plug off of here to see if there was any, like where it was spliced in, and put those wires right into the socket, and it still didn't come to life. So that's probably going to be a John Deere part. So we're going to have to find one of those. It's probably, you know, $150 part or something. Stupid, but
because it's green.
Yeah, because it's green. And then while you're there, you can get the part number and then cross over to a Wick's filter, and then be able to mess around with that once we got it the batteries up to snuff. And yeah, just give that a little tighten there or something. It's probably good to go. And put her all back together, and then she'll be a 2012.